Good morning everyone, welcome back to this channel. Today we are going to start our chapter number 6, that is Graphics in Microsoft Word 2010. As we all know, MS Word is the powerful word processor. It helps us to edit, format and add different graphical object in our document. It has a flexibility to convert our document in a documentation for printing. Today we are going to learn how to add different graphical object in our MS Word document for making it more illustrative and enhancing the representation of our document. Today we are going to learn in this video how to add word art in our text document and how to add clip art. So for better understanding, let's move to the laptop screen.
Graphical components. Graphical components are the integral part of documentation. As a document with a proper illustration always help to understand the content in a better manner. Moreover, when we create documents like a project report or poster etc., or illustrations or a graphic, plays a very important role in these. In MS Word we get a easy method, a easy way to make our document a readable with the present of many graphical object. There are many graphical object which we can use in our document. Now we will see how to use word art. So first of all we will learn how to create a new word document. There are different methods for creating a new Word document. First is you can right click over the mouse button. Then you will find here a new option. Here you will go to the Microsoft Word document. This is the first method where you can create your new Word document. And the next method is you have to go here at the start button and you will search here Microsoft Word. After getting the Microsoft Word here, again you will find one blank, new blank document will appear on your screen. So this way we can create a new document for our practice. Now word art. Word art is a gallery of text styles which help to add special effects in the document, like changing the shape of inserted text, adding gradient effects etc. Word art is added in a text placeholder which can be moved or repositioned anywhere on the document. For using word art, first we need some text on our document. As you can see, I am adding some text in my document so that later on we will use word art over these. Adding word art. This I have added the text in my document. Now we will see how to add word art in our these text. Click on the document to select the position where word art is to be inserted. As we have already created one text, we have written some text over the blank document. Now we will use word art. For using word art, we have to go to insert option, and from here you will find a word art option at the right side, and according to our choice we can select the word art for our written document. If you want to change it, again you will go back to that word document and you can select here your desired text. Whatever text you want to write here, you can write over this box, and there will be an OK option. That means you are confirmed you have to apply that word art in your text. So whenever you want to apply word art in your text, the first option is you have to select it. Let's try another word art. First, we have to select it. We are already here in an insert option, and now you can see here word art. So this way we can increase or decrease the size of our word art. Alright, next we will learn adding special effect. We can add a special effect to the inserted word art like shadow, reflection, glow effect, etc. So let's go back and get the last word art. This was our last word art. Now we will add some special effect. For adding some special effect, we will go back to the word art style that is located in the text effect option. It is located at the format tab. You can see here at the last option, this is format tab. When we will click over this format tab, all the options in the ribbon will get changed. Okay, so here you will find different options, different special effects which we can apply in our document. As I have written happy birthday, alright, so I want to change the position. First we will learn how to change the position in a blank document or in our document. This is a sheet. Now I want to change the position of this text in my single page only. So we will go at the position group. As you can see here, when I am putting the cursor over these different styles or different text wrapping options, automatically our document is also getting change. It is not getting change, but it is showing us the preview, how it will look when we will apply this effect in our document. So I want our this happy birthday should come at the here. Okay, so this way we have changed the position of this whole text in our document. One more thing, you can see here when I am here in the ribbon, you cannot see the format tab right now. Why? Because for getting format tab, first we have to click over the text, then we will get the format tab in our ribbon. So click over the text, then we will get format tab. Now second, what we will learn, 3D effect, how we can apply 3D effect in our text. So for applying 3D effect, we will go at the 3D effect corner, and again the same thing you can see, when we will put the cursor over these effect, automatically we can see the preview of our effect in our document. Alright, so this way, before using these effect in our original document, we can see the preview. Alright, this is, you can see here it is given so many effect which we can apply in our document, and we can enhance the appearance of our document. Alright, first we have studied how we can change the position of our text. Next we have studied 3D effect. Now next we will see how we can apply the shadow effect. You can see there is a quite similarity between shadow effect and 3D effect. This is a 3D effect, right? We can see the depth in our text. Now what will happen if we will apply the shadow effect in our document? Let's see. Yes, the position of our text shadow is changing when we are putting our cursor on the different shadows effect. You can see the background of this text is changing frequently when I am putting the cursor on different effects. Alright, I hope now you can understand the difference between the shadow effect and 3D effect. Alright, till now we have studied how to add text in our document and how we can add word art in our document. Then we studied how to change the position of the text in our document. Later we have studied how to apply 3D effect and shadow effect in our document. Now next we will study about changing the shape of our text. Now how we can change the shape of our text? The word art text can be displayed in a various shapes. So for selecting the word art shape, first we will go to the format tab. As earlier I told you, for using format tab, we have to get this blue dots outlined in our text. Then only we will get the format tab in our document. For changing shape, you can see here in our format tab, there is one option, change shape. When we will go here at the change shape, again we will find multiple options. Now here you can see change shape option contain two different more option, that is follow path and second is wrap. Follow path is basically a kind where the text is not overlapping each other, right? You can see in a single row it is appearing, okay? And in a wrap option you can see somewhere both shadow and text are connecting with each other, right? Okay, so this way we can add or we can change the shape of our text as well. Now next we will study about inserting clip art. Now what is clip art? Clip art is a built-in collection of ready-made images provided with the MS Office components. We can use these clip art in our document to illustrate its contents. Clip art is just like a image, which is some clip arts are already created by MS Office. I hope you very well know what is MS Office. MS Office is a package of application software. Now, how many application software contained by MS Office? There are many application software contained by MS Office, such as MS Word, MS Excel, MS PowerPoint, MS Paint. Okay, so there are so many application software which help us to complete our document. Now come back to the point, inserting clip art. Now how we can add clip art in our document? So for adding clip art, we will go back to the insert tab. Now here you can see in the illustration option, the second group is a clip art. When you will click over this clip art, another dialog box will appear at the right side of your screen. Okay, one more thing, for adding clip art, the internet connection is required. If you are not having the internet connection, you can only use those clip art which are already saved in your this software, means which already installed in your MS Word. So I am using internet so I can find out balloons for using in my document. Now you can see different types of clip arts are available here. Now what we will do for taking this clip art to in our document, we will use drag and drop option. I hope you know what is drag and drop. We will just put the cursor over the clip art and drag it into our document. All right, you can see here. This way I have added one clip art in our document. Now, according to your choice, if you want it a small picture, if you want a small clip art, you can decrease the size. All right, if you want to increase the size, what you will do, you will just put the cursor at the corner points and drag it towards the border. Okay, so this way we can add our clip art. Okay, now we have used the word art, we have changed the position, we have added the special effect, we have even changed the shape, and last we have studied how to add a clip art. Now what if you want to add a image from your internal storage? Means suppose like I'm having this document and I'm not having internet connection, so I cannot add any image or clip art from internet. So what I will do, I will just go back in my internal storage, in my back to my storage where I have already saved some picture for adding in my document. So I will go here, I will find the document, I will find the place where I have saved my picture. As you can see, this is my little image which I want to add in my document, and this is a self-created image. So if you want to change the size of any image, if you want to increase or decrease the size, what you can do, you can just put the mouse cursor at the given points at the border of the image and slowly drag it or increase or decrease the size of image. Okay, so this is a very easy task. You can easily create. Now, if you want to change the size of your inserted image, what you will do? You can see here, when I have clicked over the image, again the format tab is opened. Now I want to change the picture's style. This is my picture which I have inserted in my document. Now I want to change the style of my picture. You can see, whenever I am selecting my styles here at the ribbon, we can see lots of styles are given here. When you will select these style, automatically the inserted picture will also get changed. Alright, so that's all for today. I hope you understood each and everything.